Hello, this is Abby Jo, and welcome to my cottage kitchen. Today we're going to be making a whole bunch of freezer meals together. So we're going to be making some homemade chili today. We're going to be making pizza crust because pizza crust are something that I use all the time, and I really need to fill up my freezer because we've been using them and I have to always restock. So it's definitely a pizza crust restock day. I'm going to be making quiches, which are so wonderful to freeze. Just pull them out and then you have these beautiful quiches. You can either have them defrosted or you can warm them up, and they're just so great to have on hand. And I feel like everybody really enjoys a delicious creamy quiche. We're also going to make meatballs, and then we're going to make our favorite pourable pot pie casserole. That's something that I always make on a freezer meal day because I always take the leftovers that I've had from usually a Sunday dinner and I make pot pies with it. And so if I have the leftovers, might as well get a couple pot pies into the freezer, and it just is a great staple. And it's really one of those meals that my kids love, and it's always nice to have on hand. A new favorite that we're making today is the slow cooker honey garlic chicken. It's so delicious. You get it all marinated, put into Ziploc bags, freeze it in the freezer, and then when you're ready, you're just gonna dump that into a crock pot, cook it for 4 to 6 hours, and then you're gonna add some really delicious noodles to it, and it makes such a quick, delicious meal. When you're preparing for a big freezer meal cook day like this, I always try to envision 20 to 30 meals that I'm gonna make using 5 to 6 different recipes. And then, you know, you get that number that you're looking for, anywhere between 20 and 30 meals for the whole month. However, a lot of people aren't going to just eat those 5 or 6 meals every single, you know, day for the entire month. For me, freezer meals are there in the freezer when I need them, and I usually cycle through within 3 months. I love to have all those different things in the freezer. So I usually do one good freezer meal cook day a month, and that gets me all these different varieties of freezer meals in my freezer space that I can, you know, switch out and try and make and have for lunches and have for dinners when things are busy, when you're getting things done outside, project, school, coming home after shopping all day. That is when I love to use my freezer meals. So we're gonna get busy making the honey garlic chicken in just 1 minute, but first I want to get some things going. I love to make sure that when I'm working on something, there's something else cooking, then there's more than one thing going on and I'm accomplishing a lot more. So I need to get some beans into the Instapot for the chili, and I need to get some bacon going for the chili and also for the quiches. I love using my Instapot. It's such a handy tool for meal prep. I'm adding about 2.5 pounds of beans, both pinto and red kidney bean. I pressure cook the beans at high pressure for 40 minutes. I love cooking bacon on a sheet pan in my oven at 400 degrees, anywhere from 8 to 12 minutes. So we just got the Instapot going with the beans, and we've got the bacon in the oven cooking for the chili and for the quiche. One of the things that I do to keep my day running smoothly with a big freezer meal bake like this with all the different things that you have to cook and bake is I have my notebook and I just have my list, and I have recipes and just like what's next, what I need to get out. I just jot all these little things down for myself so I can look down and be like, this is next, this is next. And the other thing that I love to do is the night before, I make sure that all the meat that I'm going to use is defrosted in the fridge and ready to go for the next day. And any ingredients that I need, I just kind of gather them and set them on the counter or a table that I need for the next day that's like dry ingredients. So it's out, it's ready, and I'm organized. I found this great chicken honey garlic recipe on Instagram through a reel at Bored at Lunch. And I'll put that handle down in the recipe area in the description. But I found it there, and it was such a fun little reel. He just plopped everything in the crock pot and he said, that he didn't have exact measurements, but he just kind of gave a guideline. You can go and look at his Instagram to see that guideline. But what I did is I took his guideline and I doubled his recipe. Everything is in grams and milliliters on his reel because he's from England. And so I basically just took that and just translated it into cups and ounces and stuff like that. And then a few things I added a little bit more of and a little less of just to make it work for freezer meals. I cubed up the chicken and pre-measured out about 4 cups of chicken per Ziploc bag. I add 3/4 of a cup of soy sauce per bag. Half a cup of chicken broth. Half a cup of honey. 2 tablespoons of hoisin sauce. 1/3 cup of sriracha sauce, 2 tablespoons of ginger, 2 tablespoons of garlic. I use 2 tablespoons of cornstarch with 1/4 cup of cold water to make a cornstarch slurry to thicken the sauce when it cooks. Shake it real good in a mason jar so there are no lumps. I will leave the amount of everything that I used in this recipe below in the description. I set up a little assembly line and just got right to it. I ended up with 6 bags of a delicious honey garlic chicken. I'm going to stack it in the freezer flat until it's frozen. The next meals that we're going to make together is my homemade chili and my pourable pot pie crust that I have on the blog. I always make it with leftovers and then I use my pourable pot pie crust and pour it on. And it's just a great, easy meal that the kids love and it's quick to make. You use leftovers. It's a win-win. However, my chili recipe, I don't have a recipe for you guys because it's more of a method. I taught it to my daughters. It's just using like basically a certain amount of beans and then different kinds of meats. And then I add in some spices and diced tomatoes. And so I'm just going to tell you guys kind of what I do. And then you can kind of add and take away from that and make your own specialized homemade chili. So I'm going to get the chili going and work on the pot pie while that chili is cooking. First things first, I'm going to let the steam out of the Instapot. The beans are all cooked. Then I'm going to be chopping up the bacon and onions and getting the hamburger going. I cooked up 1.5 pounds of bacon and divided it up for the chili and the quiches. I had 3 of these sausages left in the fridge that need to be used, so I sliced those up for the chili. I'm using 1 large onion and some of the bacon grease, about 1 large tablespoon, to saute the hamburger and onions. I'm using 2 pounds of hamburger. I made a huge pork roast for Sunday dinner and we had a large chunk of it left over for our pot pies and I'm just coarsely chopping it into chunks. As you can see, I'm adding the large onion diced into the hamburger mixture. And now I'm going to add leftover mashed potatoes to the casserole mixture. I had leftover gravy that is nicely gelled. I'm going to dump that in as well. A little leftover corn, and I grabbed several bags of peas and corn to add some more veg to the pot pie. It may not look all that beautiful of a mixture, but when it cooks, it's like hot mashed potatoes, meat and gravy and veg under a fluffy crust. It's quite good. The recipe for the pourable pot pie crust is on my blog. I will link all recipes below in the description and I'll pin it in the comments. When I put a casserole in the deep freezer, I like to wrap it in saran wrap first, and then I add the tin foil, and that just gives double protection and makes it sturdier to stack. Just remember, when you go to defrost and bake these, take the saran wrap off. You do not want melted plastic in your food. I'm adding cooked beans and bacon and sugar to the sauteed onion and hamburger. I like to add 1 to 2 quarts of my home canned tomatoes, some organic tomato sauce, and I didn't have any fresh garlic on hand today, so I added some of my bottled minced garlic. I like to add some kind of barbecue sauce to my chili. I always do. I also add some sweetener, usually honey or brown sugar. I'm adding salt, paprika, chili powder, garlic powder, and some cayenne powder. I always tell my girls, taste as you go until you get the right amounts. The secret ingredient is to add 1 to 2 chipotle peppers with a couple tablespoons of the sauce. I love these heavy-duty freezer containers. They wash up great so you can reuse them. I'll link them down below if you're interested in them. Time for some hot tea and a bowl of chili for a lunch tea time. All right, let's get making some pie crust. I'm gonna be making 4 pie crusts. Actually, I already have one from the freezer, so I'm actually gonna be making 3 pie crusts. And I'm gonna use this frozen one, handy, because I want 4 quiche Lorraines today, and I'm using my grandma's recipe. And I'm gonna walk you through each step of making the pie crust and filling up with the delicious quiche Lorraine. If you head over to this link right here, you will go to the video on pie making, and it shows you step-by-step how to make pie crust, how to do it by hand, and also with the food processor. I'm adding 2.5 cups of flour, 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 cup of butter chopped into cubes. Mix that real good with a fork, pastry blender, or your hands until it has a nice crumbly texture. Add in 1/4 to 1/2 cup of water with 1 teaspoon of apple cider vinegar. Stir that in and then work the dough with your hand by gently kneading it until it all comes together. At this point, you can chill your dough in the refrigerator, but I usually never have time for that step, and my crust always rolls out just fine. Divide the dough into 2 balls. Usually you'll have enough scraps from both pies to make 1 more smaller pie crust. Don't be afraid of pie crust. It's very forgiving, and if you get a rip in the crust, just gently push it back together with your fingers. I crimp the edges of the pie and prick the bottom crust with a fork. Mm-hmm. I always fold my crust into quarters. It's easier to move to the pie pan. I'm chopping up one large onion to sauté for the quiche Lorraine. Onions always get to me. Coarsely chopping the bacon, I'm going to be sprinkling a little bit in the bottom of each crust. Next, I sprinkle in cheese. Whatever I have on hand, cheddar, Swiss, and mozzarella are all great options. Adding in the sautéed onion, which brings such a nice flavor to this dish. And a sprinkling of peas. I tripled my grandma's recipes for the egg filling. It worked because two of my pie crusts are on the smaller side. And now they're ready to go into a hot oven. All right, we're gonna make some meatballs today, and I'm gonna basically show you guys just a simple method that I use. I don't have a recipe, kind of like my chili. I just kind of stick with some basics, and that is using one egg per 1 pound, about 1 cup of breadcrumbs or anything. You could use oatmeal. And then I add in a little bit of milk a lot of times, and then I keep the spices down really simple, like a little bit of salt, garlic, maybe cayenne, because maybe later I might want to take these meatballs and put them into teriyaki sauce or maybe a really good spaghetti and meatball dish. So you want to kind of keep it not too spicy so you can put it in different things or even a really good meatball sandwich. So I defrosted a little bit of zucchini to put into the meatballs. I always like to sneak in a little bit of veg. You could also use like grated carrots or some diced tomatoes. Those are all really good things. You can really put any kind of veg in that you want. And then I also want to add a little bit of Parmesan cheese. I've got out of the freezer today. And that's basically all that I'm gonna do. And then I'll just roll those up. I like to brown them first in the oven, and then I'll flash freeze them in the freezer, put them in bags, and then they're ready to go. And then I can just dump them out for whatever I need later. I had a little bit of this cream and egg mixture left over from the quiches, and I am just gonna use that right in the meatloaf. A lot of times I'll add half a cup of milk, and that's something that is really, really good, is to be flexible in the kitchen. And if you have a little bit of leftover of something, think, what can I add that in? Especially when you're doing a big cook day. So a little bit of egg and cream, perfect for the meatballs, you know? If you have a little bit of veg, sneak it into something, or maybe one of the pot pies, or, you know, just reuse whatever you have. And if there's leftovers, put it in another dish. So then you have no food waste. All right, so I have about a little over 2 pounds of hamburger right here. I'm just gonna dump it right in to that cream and egg mixture. Then I'm gonna add 2 eggs. If you feel like you need more, you can add some more. It's all good. I've got about, I believe, 2 cups of breadcrumbs here. And then I've got my zucchini that I defrosted. out of the fridge, just a little bit here. Just gonna pop it in. Add a little salt. I like to add a little cayenne, not too much, but I do like the little bit of a zing. And I always add a little bit of garlic powder because I like garlic. Again, do the measurements to your taste. And then I'm gonna add a little bit of this grated Parmesan, probably like about a cup. It's kind of chunky, but it will melt really nice when they're cooking, so I think it'll be really good. You can get your hands in there and just mix up by hand, or you could start off with a spoon, but you are going to be rolling them, so just make sure your hands are nice and clean. Got the cheese right in there, the vegetables. Okay, I think I'm gonna start rolling these. All right, let's get these rolled into balls. And you know, one way that you can make these really uniform is using a ice cream scoop. And I'm just gonna eye it. I don't care if they're not perfectly the same size, but I try to get close. So we got 30 meatballs here. Those big chunks of white you see is the big chunks of Parmesan in there and zucchini. And these will brown up so beautiful and be so tasty. They smell good. And basically it's a little over 2 pounds and breadcrumbs and zucchini and cheese. You made 30 meatballs. We're gonna make pizza dough right now. And that's one of my favorite things to do on a big freezer meal day like this. I do it every time because I like my freezer to have a lot of crust in it for my kids, for myself. It's just a quick go-to. I like it because you can set it on the counter and in 1 hour it's defrosted, you roll it out and you have pizza for lunch or dinner, and it's just a great thing to have. So I'm gonna make 8 of them today and let's get making pizza crust. My basic pizza crust recipe is on the blog. I'm doubling the recipe, so 2 cups of warm water, 2 tablespoons of dry yeast, whisk that together real good and add 1 teaspoon of salt and 4 teaspoons of olive oil. To that, I add 5 cups of flour. I knead it with my KitchenAid until it comes together. And then as you can see, it's still a little sticky. That's how it should be. I hand knead it a couple of times and roll it into a ball. Then I divide the dough into 2 balls and I knead and tuck them a little before adding them to a freezer bag. I like to spray a little avocado oil into the bags to keep them from sticking. Then I keep repeating until I get 8 beautiful pizza crusts. The quiche are done and cooling before I wrap them and put them in the freezer. I couldn't live without my dough scraper. It helps to clean up the counters too. I will make sure to link it down below. Now for the meatballs, I bake them at 400 for 18 to 20 minutes. I squeeze out all the air and flatten the dough balls into the bag, and they're ready to go into the freezer. So what I like to do with the honey garlic chicken, I have 6 individual meals over here with that, is I like to either serve it on rice or add the noodles to it, which is like my favorite way. And then I like to steam some vegetables on the side, and that kind of rounds out the meal. And as most of you guys know, we love to have pizza on Friday night. So with my pizza, I usually roll out pizza and I cut up carrot sticks or celery sticks or both. Sometimes I add a salad, so that's how I round off that meal. As I mentioned before, we have 30 meatballs here, so I can make meatball sandwiches, I can make, you know, spaghetti and meatballs, we can have teriyaki meatballs with rice, so that's a really good meal, and then just a salad on the side. I love quiche. Quiche can be, for me, a breakfast thing, a lunch thing, or a dinner thing. I love adding a little fruit salad to the side, and it just ends up being a perfect little meal. For my pourable pot pies, I like to usually add some fruit on the side, like canned fruit, like applesauce or peaches, and then some steamed vegetables. I love chili. It's definitely a favorite in this household. We love to just have a bowl of hot chili with a little bit of cheese on top and cornbread on the side. But some other ways that we also use it, we add it to our nachos. Nachos with chili on top is really delicious. We add it to a baked potato, and we also add it on top of our French fries or even our chili dogs. Thank you so much for joining me in my cottage kitchen today, and I would love to hear from you guys. What are you stocking your freezer up with? I always get lots of great ideas from you guys. Thank you so much for joining me, and have a blessed week.